I built my home in 1995, this custom home that I built from scratch. I have fancy cars, I have a very substantial bank account, my medical practice, and I was married at the time, but unfortunately went through a divorce in 1998. But I remember just standing out in front of the house saying, I have all these things, but I'm absolutely miserable, lonely, and empty on the inside. Some very dear friends who actually live in the neighborhood, we would drive around on Saturdays or Sundays and we would just visit churches at random. One day we actually happened upon Harvest. I came to the service. Pastor James is doing a three-part series on romantic love. Just the thing I want to hear going through a divorce. Right in the middle of the sermon, he spoke about a particular conversation between a husband and a wife. It was a theoretical conversation, but it was precisely, and I do mean precise, the exact same conversation that occurred in my home. And at that point, I just broke down and I started crying. God really touched my heart and said, okay, do you want to do this for real now? A new purpose, a new meaning to a true, intimate relationship with Christ and really wanting to know Him and love Him more.
We've had the privilege of knowing Tony for about 20 years, from the time I first remember meeting him to, you know, just kind of years down the road with him. Here was a guy who was passionate about his faith. He shared the gospel with people, and we got the chance to meet people that he had impacted with his life and brought them to church.
On Wednesdays, I would get so excited because I would think, okay, only two or three more days and I can go to church. Started participating in ushering. I was in great physical shape. Academically, I was doing very well. I'm in control of everything and I can dictate what is or isn't going to happen. In February of 2017, I was training for a CrossFit meet. Literally at random, I started to notice some twitching. I didn't want to stop. I wanted to continue to train, and I'm Tony Easley. I can push through this. Very quickly after the twitching began in one leg, it then began in the other leg, and then it started to move in my entire body. And at that point, I became very, very worried that maybe something significant is going on here, so I better seek medical care. They ran an EMG, which is a test to test your muscles. They initially just said, we are suspicious of a neuromotor disease, but they wouldn't specify what, and I am worried. I mean, I was literally shaking, and I don't know what came over me. I just said, are you testing me for ALS? And he said, yes. And with the knowledge I do have ALS, is that your life's over. Not only do you have ALS, that it is progressive, it is diffuse throughout your body, and that it has already started to affect your respiratory muscles. That's unfortunately what results in ultimately your demise is your respiratory muscles fail.
When Rick told me, I just started to cry. And then just this heavy weight on my chest. Because when you know Tony, always physically fit and healthy and well,
strong.
I had to think he was going to walk through this. Just was really hard to put it all together.
In my closet, with the door closed, on my knees, crying out to God, I have no control of anything and I just can't catch my breath. My body is deteriorating at a pretty rapid pace. Probably about 4 to 5 months, I went from limping to wearing an ankle brace, to using a cane, to using a walker, to where I'm almost wheelchair bound now.
Well, as a doctor, he knows exactly how this is going to play out.
Yeah.
And I can only imagine how he has to rein his thoughts in. But I know the times that we've gone to visit Tony, he's just asking us to pray for peace.
It literally feels like God has stripped me bare. He's stripped me of my health. He's stripped me of my profession. He is saying, I want you, Tony. I want you. Because even in this, I want you to glorify me. To get from rejection to acceptance is just go to the foot of the cross and you see him on that cross and you see what he accepted for me, to see his love for me and his sacrifice for me. How could not I not accept a cross that he's given me? You've put this before me and I don't like it and I don't want it. But if you allowed it, then I'm going to accept this. You're God, I'm not. And when you're in a fog and you can't see anything, God is with you. Don't take a step without him. That's the way that I live right now. When I wake up in the morning, it's, Lord, give me the strength to get dressed and go to the kitchen and have breakfast. After that, then you give me the strength for whatever's next.
That vibrant smile and still praising the Lord. That's Tony. That's because he's got a real relationship with God. And any chance he gets with all the workers that have been coming in and out of the house, he's sharing Christ with them.
You know, you just see this strong, foundational faith that isn't changing when life has got really, really hard.
My identity is not in being a doctor. My identity is not in the home that I live. It's not in the friends that I have. My identity is hidden in Christ. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise will continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make its boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear it and rejoice. Oh, come magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together.